Dear students, today I am going to explain subtopic from the distribution law, that is Henry's law. So see towards the PPTs for the further understanding. It's a statement. At constant temperature, the solubility of a gas in a liquid is proportional to the pressure of the gas above it. Means the condition is that the temperature should be constant one. At constant temperature, the solubility of the gas in a liquid is proportional to the pressure of the gas above it. That is the statement of the Henry's law. Henry's law may be mathematically expressed as C is equal to Kp, where C is the solubility or the concentration of the gas in the given liquid, K is a constant called Henry's constant, and P is the pressure of the gas. Then explanation regarding the Henry's law. Henry's law is in fact a form of distribution law. If a vessel containing a liquid and a gas is shaken at equilibrium, the gas can be regarded as distributed between the liquid phase A and space above phase B. In this case, liquid is taken here and gas is above it. It is a space phase B and it is phase A. Means whatever the gas which we have taken here, that gas is shaken with the liquid vigorously. On standing for some time, what happens? These gas molecules are going to be distributed into the liquid phase. This concentration of gas which is distributed into the liquid, this concentration is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas. That is the Henry's law. Let C1 be the concentration of gas in phase B and C be the concentration of the gas in phase A. Applying the distribution law, C upon C, C1 is equal to Kd. C upon C1 is equal to Kd. This is the equation which we get here by applying the distribution law. Molar concentration of gas is proportional to its pressure P, and hence this equation is converted later on. C is equal to Kp. This is the Henry's law equation. Means in this diagram, gas is taken in the as a phase B and liquid is taken as a phase A. In this case, this gas having whatever the pressure, that pressure is creating the impact on the distribution of gas in the liquid phase. If the gas pressure is more, then the distribution of gas in the liquid will be more. If the gas pressure is low, then the distribution of gas in the liquid will be low. Means the concentration of gas dissolved or distributed in the liquid is directly proportional to the concentration of gas which above the liquid. This is the Henry's law. For the further detailed explanation, I am explaining it with the help of board. So
now I am explaining Henry's law. William Henry in 1803 given this law. This law is a another form of the or one form of the distribution law. What is distribution law? Whenever solute X itself distributes into the two immiscible solvents at a constant temperature, then the concentration of X in solute A upon concentration of X in solute B is equal to Kd. Means what? Whenever we are taking the two solutions or the solvents, solvent A and solvent B, and we are adding some solute, then what will happen? Solute X is distributing in this solvent and another solvent also, and that ratio C1 upon C2 is equal to Kd. That is the normal distribution law. This is the another form of the distribution law. Henry's law is nothing but the another form of the distribution law. What it says? It says that at a constant temperature, gas distributes or becomes soluble in the liquid with which it is in contact. That dissolution or solubility of that gas is directly proportional to its pressure. Means what? We have taken here gas in the upper compartment and liquid in the lower compartment, and that gas and liquid are shaken vigorously and kept on a stable ground for some time. What will happen? The gas will be dissolved or become soluble into the liquid also. Means the concentration of gas goes into the liquid. Means some of the gas gets distributed into the liquid. Then what is the relation between the gas pressure and the concentration or change in concentration in liquid? That is studied in the Henry's law. At the constant temperature, gas is distributing into the liquid. That distribution is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas. Means what? Whenever the gas pressure is more, then what will happen? The more gas will be distributed into the liquid. And whenever the gas pressure is low, then the distribution of gas or solubility of the gas in the liquid will be low. Means the solubility of the gas in the liquid is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas. And hence, that Henry's law is mathematically put in this way. C is equal to Kp, where C is the concentration or the solubility of the gas in liquid, and K is the proportionality constant. That constant is called the Henry's constant also, and P is the pressure of the gas in phase B. Explanation. This is regarding the statement. Then explanation. What is the statement? At constant temperature, the solubility of a gas is directly proportional to its pressure. Means when the pressure is more, solubility will be more, and that is mathematically given as C is equal to Kp. This is the phase B, this is the phase A. Phase B is a gas, phase A is a liquid. Here we are taking the gas, here is a liquid. These two are shaken together vigorously and kept on a stable ground for some time. After some time, what will happen? There will be an equilibrium set up between them in this way. After achieving the equilibrium or establishing the equilibrium, what will happen? The pressure of the gas decreases and the concentration of gas in liquid phase increases. means what? Some of the gas gets distributed or they become soluble into the liquid phase. This solubility of the gas is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas. This principle is used in the soda water preparation. In the different soda waters, factory owners or the workers are dissolving or making soluble CO2 into the bottles under pressure near about 4 atmosphere. This is a bottle of the soda water, for example, in which a liquid is taken here, which we are using as a soft drink, or it may be used in the beers and so on. In this case, CO2 is dissolved or made soluble under near about 4 atmosphere pressure. Here the gas CO2 gas, and this gas is having 4 atm atmosphere. Under high atmosphere, it is mixed with that liquid, and due to that reason, CO2 is dissolved into the bottle, liquid containing bottle, or that CO2 gets distributed into the liquid in that bottle. Whenever we are opening the lid of the bottle, then what will happen? This bottle will be open to the atmosphere, to the 1 atmosphere pressure. Whenever we are opening it, then what happens? The gas, which that is the CO2, which is dissolved into the given bottle, start to escape outside the bottle in the form of bubbles or the brisk effervescence. And it attains the 1 atmosphere, it happens at the 1 atmosphere pressure. Finally, what will happen? All the CO2 escaping or relieving from that bottle, and a soft drink is remaining behind. This evolution of gas or escaping of gas starts or continued up to the equilibrium, up to the partial pressure of the CO2, that is the 0.01 atmosphere. Means partial pressure of the CO2 is 0.001 atmosphere. Means gas is dissolved or distributed under the pressure in the soda water drinks. Whenever we are opening that bottles by opening the lid, then what will happen? That compressed or pressurized gas from that soft drink start to come out as the bubbles or the brisk effervescence, and it is happening at the 1 atmospheric pressure whenever we are opening, and it is continued to leave the CO2 gas, and soft drink is remaining behind. Means this dissolution of gas into the liquid is in a proportion of pressure, directly proportion of the pressure. That principle is used in the soft drinks. C1 is the pressure of the gas or the gas concentration of gas in the liquid. C is the concentration of gas in liquid. C1 is the concentration of the gas. Then we can write down this equation in this way. C upon C1 is equal to KD. But this C1 is the molar concentration of the gas, that is equivalent to the pressure, and hence we can replace the C1 by P. C1 is replaced by P. Therefore, C upon P is equal to K, that is also constant. Therefore, we can write down equation C is equal to KP by shifting P towards the right side of the equation, and we will get the final equation C is equal to Kp. This is the mathematical equation of the Hindley's law. Hindley's law is a law which states that at a constant temperature, the solubility of a gas is directly proportional to its pressure P. Means the pressure is more, the solubility will be more. This is the principle or this is the law of the Hindley. And the different limitations of the law. This law is feasible only in that condition whenever the moderate temperature and pressure conditions are present. And this law is holding good results whenever the dilute solutions are studied. Whenever there is an association or dissociation in the liquid, then this law cannot be obeyed or this law does not give the proper results. Means this law is applicable only whenever the gas molecules are in a normal condition. At the same time, whenever gas shows the reaction between the liquid molecules, then this law does not obey.